Beautiful church. I have to thank Reverend Tyler and his wonderful wife, Leslie, as well, not the least of which because he scheduled me to follow Pastor Johnson. So I feel like that's a great way. But there's no doubt Pastor Johnson laid down the law today, and as did Reverend Tyler. I want to talk a little bit about language, because we've been here before. We were here 10 years ago with the state takeover, when the state of Pennsylvania told us that we were bankrupt, that our children were failing, and it was time to fix the school system. So they came in here with their managers and their portfolios and their offers of choice, and we expanded this system into a $3.2 billion system. A $3.2 billion system that still didn't buy lower class sizes, that still didn't put a nurse in every single school every single day, that still didn't put a library and a librarian into every single school, that still didn't buy our children fresh food in the cafeteria, that still didn't put in a playground for kids to play in and gave them maybe a concrete slab for 30 minutes a day. So let's not forget that it takes a lot of money to keep people poor. $3.2 billion. They talk about portfolio management, high-performing seat expansion. Who are they talking to? Because they're not talking to any of us. Not a single one of us understands that kind of language. Not a single one of us heard the word child in that language, or parent involvement in that language, or a caring teacher in that language. Not a single one of us understands what that means. There's not a word about meaningful teacher relationships. There's not a word about more books. There's not a word about enriched curriculum instead of this test prep that they give us. A year. You know what our medical situation in this school district is that they say to the public? That they will take care of the medically fragile. They will take care of the medically fragile children in our district. That is the health care option that they promised the children of this city. That is a disgrace. The school district chief recovery officer talks about let me use his words because they're unusual. He talks about an intimate, hand-in-glove relationship. Hand in glove with a consultant that he has met for 6 to 8 weeks and that he has now brought into the school district of Philadelphia that Pastor Johnson rightly recognizes the Boston Consulting Group. For that, he paid $1.4 million. So $1.4 million, 6 to 8 weeks, and you have an intimate relationship. But to the very people of the city, to the children, to the parents of this city, where are we? Where's our voice in any of this? What's your relationship to us? There's a big difference between a short term. I also want to talk a little bit about living within our means. The new language is coming out of City Hall from our own leadership. This is not from outside. This is from our own leadership. So there's a difference between the short term financial crisis, which we have and which we have known about for a very long time. And then there's a big difference between that and recognizing that in a long term state of penury and poverty for our kids, which is called living within your means. What does it mean to live within our means when our children get $13,372 a year and right across the border, not even 5 miles away, in Lower Merion, it's $26,000. Any city official who says that we now need to live within our means is not speaking the language of this community. There's a governor out there who said that he cut $1 billion from our state education budget, $1.1 billion in fact over the last 2 years. He called it, when he passed that budget, it took up $1.1 billion again out of state education funds. He said that this was a budget that separated the must-haves from the nice-to-haves. And guess where we landed? Nice-to-have. And let's not forget that this is a governor when Chester went bankrupt, told the parents in that community that when their payroll would run out, when their schools might close, you should have gone to charter. So don't tell us that charters are an answer here. This is a governor also who has to go on TV and actually announce that he is not, quote, a heartless tin man. Governor, if you have to announce that you are not a heartless tin man, you are certainly a heartless tin man. Don't buy into the fact that this is a fiscal plan. This is absolutely not a fiscal plan. I want us to think about one thing. It takes 40 schools to close next year. 40 schools saves you $33 million. Putting 40% of children into charters, 30,000 additional students, $270 million in the deficit column. You tell me, you stand up in front of this community, you tell me that that's a fiscal plan. That's not a fiscal plan. So we don't buy the fiscal plan argument. 40 schools next year, 64 schools total in the city will devastate every single community all across the city. So then when they come back and tell you that they want to pay higher taxes, when we've got to do all this stuff, when we've got to buy into the plan, when we've got to support them, because it's a crisis. Don't forget what we buy. We buy devastation in our communities. We buy closures of schools. We don't buy the things that we needed to, that we've always been asking for. We want lead out of our drinking water. We want a decent teacher in every classroom. We want a functioning principal that cares about their community. We want books in our classrooms. And I will echo Pastor Johnson when he says, this is not a time for us to be sitting down. This is not a time necessarily for us to find all the answers at 440. As we know, they've had plenty of time to give those answers to us. And they have not come back with them. So those answers aren't found at 440. They're here, in this building, in Mother Bethel AME tonight. This is where the answers come. We may not have the titles, but we do have the power. Get up on our feet, walk out the door, and tell every single official this is not working for us. We're here to